Okay, next, we are going to have a look on the factory manufacturing process flow. Okay, the process to produce glue lamp. Okay, so there are 6 steps. Oh, sorry, 10 steps of producing glue lamp. Okay, so firstly, it's about the grind of the member must be in the longitudinal direction. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, when you want to lay or glue a piece of timber or two or more layers, the main condition is that the grind must be parallel, okay, selari, urat-urat itu mesti selari, okay, itu syarat utama ni lah, as I mentioned earlier. So make sure you check the grind must be parallel lah, mesti selari, okay. And the lamination are stress graded to ensure they meet the specified structural grade. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, I think the first video. Okay, Malaysia ni kaya dengan timber. Okay, and timber in Malaysia will be specifically graded. Okay, we have a grade A, B, C and so on. So, in order to make sure that your glue lamp will produce to have a strong connection when you glue a piece of timber, you need to make sure that you are using a timber from the same grade. Itu syarat dia. Okay, so let's say you want to glue 10 layers of timber to get the desired thickness. Nak dapatkan tebal yang you nak, you akan kena gamkan 10 keping kayu. Okay, let's say lah, kayu first tu you guna 5 jenis, you ada cengal, 5 lagi you guna merbau. It's not a problem as long as both timber ni, cengal dengan merbau ni, is a grade A ni timber, let's say. Okay, grade yang sama. So, tak ada masalah. Okay, tapi kalau merbau ni grade B, cengal ni grade A, so tak boleh. Okay, so dia kena within the same grade, even though kayu yang berlainan. Tapi grade masih sama. Okay, iaitu you kena remember lah. Right, next, before we proceed with the gluing punya proses, or lamination punya proses, we need to dry all the timber that we are going to use to form the glue lamp. Okay, so kita akan masukkan dalam drying chamber. Okay, and kita kena measure the moisture content. Tahap kelembapan kayu tu must be at least minimum 12%. Okay, so if more than that, so you kena keringkan lagi sampai dapat at least 12% of the moisture content level. Okay, barulah you boleh proceed to the next step. Right, so again, we are not starting to laminate the timber. Belum start nak gam lagi. Okay, next process, we are going to apply what we call it as a copper chrome arsenic treatment. Okay, as you are aware, timber ni is easily being attacked by termite. Okay, so kita kena properly protect the timber. So ini salah satu je. Sebelum menjadi glue lamp, every piece of timber, setiap kepingan tu kita akan protect. Okay, by carry out a copper cream arsenic treatment. Okay, so kita akan protect every piece of timber. Okay, sebelum dia jadi glue lamp, sebelum kita gamkan dia. Okay, before we laminate the timbers to in order to get the desired thickness, nak dapatkan tebal yang kita nak. Okay, mana video? Okay, nak dapatkan tebal yang kita nak. So first, we are going to laminate to get the desired length. Okay, panjang yang kita nak tu baru kita gam dulu. Okay, kita gamkan panjang yang kita nak tu, barulah kita gamkan tebal yang kita nak. Okay, itu dia punya syarat dia lah. So in order to join this is what we call it as end jointing technique, end to end. Okay, ujung ke ujung. So basically there are 4 types of end jointing technique. Okay, we have finger joint, butt joint, scuff joint and hook scuff joint. Okay, as you can see in the notes, the difference is the cross section. Okay, shape of the connection lah. Alright, but in Malaysia basically we are using finger joint. Okay, finger joint. Okay, the shape is bentuk zigzag. Okay, as you can see in the slide, okay, in the notes. Okay, so kita akan gamkan in order to get the desired length. Okay, Then barulah kita akan laminate, okay? The plane ni maksudnya kita ketamkan kayu tu untuk dapatkan thickness yang nak, okay? Panjang yang kita nak, okay? So kita akan buat properly checking, okay? Berapa thickness yang kita nak? Adakah panjang the required length has been followed the spec, okay? Dah achieve belum, okay? Dia punya apa ni panjang dia. Okay, sebelum kita proceed to the thickness punya proses. Alright, so after kita dah confirm panjang yang kita gam tu sudah mencukupi. Alright, so then we are going to proceed with the lamination process to get the required thickness. Okay, tebal. Tebal yang kita nak. Okay, so we are going to carefully apply the controlled adhesive mix on the surface of the timber lah. Okay, so kita akan apply dekat surface of the timber tu. Then kita akan letak, gamkan sehinggalah we get the desired thickness. And then after that, we are going to place the glue lamp at the mechanical or hydraulic jigs. Okay, so kita akan apply pressure. So as you can see in the notes, dia punya diagram tu. So kita akan kapit kan. Okay, kita panggil dia kapit lah dalam bahasa Melayu dia. Okay, so nak make sure every surface of the timber tu kena gam. Okay, that's why kita apply this mechanical or hydraulic jigs. So betul-betul semua kena gam. Okay, that's why kita apply pressure kat situ. Okay, so after that barulah kita remove the jigs, and then kita akan repair, kita akan trim. Okay, kita akan check strength dia. Okay, ikut tak spek. Okay, and then kita akan again, kita akan cure lagi sekali. Okay, tadi kita dah buat copper chrome arsenic treatment. Now at the final stage pun kita akan buat lagi sekali. Okay, kita akan cure glue lamp product tu pula. Overall product. Tadi setiap kepingan. Okay, so kita akan ikut size, tengok balik. Okay, betul tak size, double check. Okay, we are going to remove any glue squeeze out in the jigs. Okay, glue, so kita akan remove any defect dan sebagainya lah. So once dah ready, kita akan pack. And then kita akan deliver to the sites lah. Alright, so that's the process of glue lamp. Okay. So generally, glue lamp, as I mentioned, you can also now, regarding the design flexibility of glue lamp, you can produce a curve in your glue lamp. Okay, and later on nanti saya akan attach also a video on how to produce a curve glue lamp. And I also am going to attach a video regarding the glue lamp application around the world lah. Okay, and not only on industrial building, you can see the application of glue lamp on bridge. Okay, in Malaysia, basically, we have tested the use of glue lamp for the first project, pilot project, mini project dekat FRIM. Okay, dekat Kepung sana, is a construction of the Acacia Main Gym House. Okay, a small house. Okay, like a chalet. Okay, dia nak test sama ada glue lamp ni sesuai tak sesuai dia guna pakai kat Malaysia. So, dia buat kat frame tu dulu. Okay, siapa kalau rajin pergi jogging kat area frame tu, dekat Kepung tu, you boleh tengok ada small house made of glue lamp. Okay, so after that project has been successfully proof that glue lamp can be used in Malaysia, barulah dia apply on bigger scale dekat Tebrau. Okay, dekat Tebrau, as you can see in the notes, so a few project, a few dia punya process lah. Okay, what type of timber yang dia gunakan untuk projek tu. It's an exhibition center. Okay, dia nak expose, nak tunjukkan to Malaysian construction players that we have glue lamp, we can use glue lamp on the bigger structures. Okay, that's the main objective of developing that exhibition center in glue lamp tu lah. In Tebrau, Johor. Okay, so that's all about this topic. Okay, enjoy the video. Okay, happy fasting. Okay, and then anything about this topic, you can ask later on during the discussion session lah. Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum.